Today, you're going to learn how to make a simple mask transition using the PowerDirector mobile video editor app. It's time to get masked up. As you can see, I have a clip of a businessman running on the main track. And I want to create a transition to a man running on a treadmill. First thing that we need to do is add the clip that we'll transition to and add a mask to it. So I'm going to tap on the overlay icon. I'm going to go to the video tab. I'm going to go to the location on my device where the video is. I'm going to tap that video and I'll tap the plus sign. Then we'll go ahead and resize it by pinching out. And now we want to tap on mask. And for this, we're going to use the linear mask. We want to move our playhead to the position where the pole that we want to use comes onto the screen, because we're going to use that pole that crosses in front of the individual to create the transition. And since it's there on the screen, we're going to go ahead and place our finger over one of these rotation nodes, hold it down, and we're going to rotate it. Then we'll place our finger over this middle node, which lets us move it, and we're going to drag it all the way over to where the pole is. And because we can see some space at the edge, we're going to create a feather. We're going to use a feather of 3, but you can use whatever feather you need to go ahead and clean up the mask. Next, we need to animate the mask so it goes across the screen. So we're going to tap on add a keyframe. And now we're going to stretch the timeline all the way out so that we can see each frame and keyframe each frame as the pole goes across the screen. So I'm going to pinch out on my timeline to stretch it all the way out. And now I'm going to move my playhead over one keyframe until the pole moves. Once the pole moves, I'm going to place my finger over this position node and I'm going to drag it over to stay on the pole. And I'm going to continue doing that until the pole goes all the way across the screen. Now we need to add a duplicate of the overlay clip to cover any gaps in the mask at the end of the transition. So we're going to move over one more frame until the pole is off the screen. We're going to tap back. And we're going to tap split. Then we're going to scroll over on our toolbar and we're going to tap on duplicate. So this creates a duplicate of the second overlay clip at the end. So we're going to go all the way over to the end where that duplicate is. We're going to tap on it. We're going to hold our finger over it until it gets a yellow bounding box, and we're going to drag it to the track below. Now you might get a message saying something about it being an audio track. Just drag it over again and move it, and it'll go ahead and let you add it. So now you want to go ahead and drag this directly underneath the other overlay clip. Now you can see a bit of the old clip all the way over on the left where the mask was. So if we tap on the duplicate that we created and we tap on mask and we tap on none, it'll go ahead and get rid of that little blemish on the left-hand side of the screen and it'll cover up that gap in the transition. So now we can tap back and we can go ahead and play this. Now you're masking like a pro. If you need to learn the basics of masking, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my logo to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.